How you doing here? Okay, well, I'm trying to get as close to the screen as I can get without having to zoom in so maybe it can be read. I'm doing it in open camera with the YouTube app so that it can upload it. But my screen, it's been freezing. I mean, my Lenovo i5's been freezing up. And I thought it was just from doing certain things. I can't remember what it was. But all I did, I was, you know, surfing the web, checking emails. I decided to run a DNF update in the terminal. Oh, it's frozen. I can't show anything else but that right there. And it ran perfectly. It shows no updates. I was wanting to see if my updates were working, my automatic updates, because I turned off the DNF notifier, update notifier app, because it was just staying up all the time and wasn't going away when the updates were done. So, and that worked. I just took it out of the startup. But anyway, I copied and pasted the text like I always do of my terminal output. Put it in LibreOffice like I do very often. And the instant I pasted it in there, it froze. So I don't think, it probably doesn't have to do with what, I thought it was having to do with what apps I was running, but probably not. It's probably more random. I'm thinking there's three different big errors I need to check into on boot that I didn't have before I installed VirtualBox. After I installed VirtualBox and then installed ACMods and KMods kernel modules to make it hold back the kernel updates until VirtualBox has its updates that are, you know, that'll work with it. That was just the way it installed, and I left it that way. But they're not loading. That's one thing. And then the other thing is, it's really, I've never seen before, and that's what might be probably crashing the system. It keeps sitting there for a while, like almost 30 seconds, maybe a minute, in the middle of booting, trying to, mount the swap partition. Well, the little command line output keeps kind of changing between trying to mount up some, it's a long line, I can't ever remember it, or I can't get it written down before it goes away. But it's to do with the swap partition and the root too. But yeah, and then you get on further down, it gives up. And then you get on further down and it says it blacklisted all devices. But yet, you plug in, my USB backup drive works, you plug in a USB, it works. So I don't know what it's talking about. But it has been locking up now the last several days, three or four days. And I've been putting off messing with it because I'm trying to get the IBM web server to quit making noise, and I want to finish. Well, I guess I won't. I keep thinking I want to get, I thought I'd put it off maybe till I got mom's redone. But it could be a problem in Fedora 28 even, so I better figure all this out. If I can't figure it out, I'll just reformat mine again and not install all these apps that I did on the group install and everything. But it was okay. It was fine. It was running great until I manually installed VirtualBox and, I don't know, a couple other things. That's when it started giving trouble, just within the last week. So, I'm going to hard shut it down. It's been this way now for at least 30 minutes. And it ain't coming back. It's just flat locked up. It's not just like overwhelmed or anything like that. It's locked up. Very unusual for Fedora Linux. So I have a you call it a callus on my finger that is bugging me. So I've been meaning to sand it. I'm hard shutting it down right now. Let it get finished. Make sure it's all shut down good. Okay, now I'm going to boot it up, and what I hope is that I'll be able to capture. The thing's still recording. Looks like it. I got it as good of a good aim at the screen as I could, and I think I'm getting it all. It's hard to tell with these little phone screens. All right, now I'm going to read it off the best I can. The errors, because that's the thing, is I never get them. I tried to write them down several times. I never get them. Okay, we're running 4.17.6, whatever, kernel, Fedora 28, okay, now it's going to be really small text, so I don't even know if it'll be readable. Failed to start kernel modules, See systemctl status system d-modules-load.service for details. And in the meantime, it's on this other one. Start job running for dev mapper Fedora Lenovo i5 2D root swap, and it keeps swapping back and forth dot device. The word keeps swapping. That's that one word, swapping root, swapping root, swapping root. And it's counting down. It's been 43 seconds, 1 minute limit, okay. Swap root device, and it's just trying to mount them. Yeah, it's a dev mapper, so it's trying to mount. I mean, that looks like that's, you know, two major portions of my system, my root partition and my swap partition, that aren't mounting properly. I don't see how it could run if they wouldn't mount it. So, it'll keep on counting until, well, now it's gone 1 minute and 14 seconds. Oh, it says no limit now. At some point it gives up, though. And, it just constantly, I guess it tries to mount one and it fails, and then tries the other one, tries to mount one and that jump. The dependency failed. Resume from hibernation using device. Oh, hibernation. See, I don't use hibernation. Okay, now up in here, it gives you some readout. It says etc, well, starting Dracoot, pre-pivot and cleanup hook, etc multipath config C1F does not exist, blacklisting all devices. You can run at /sbin/mpath-C1F to create or modify etc multipath config.config. I hope I read that out well enough to understand it, because I'm probably going to have to depend on what I'm saying. And then it'll start. Right now it's reach target switch root, starting switch root. That's what it's doing right now. But yeah, those other ones don't even show up as, they don't actually show up, you know, error or caution even. On it's all green, you know, okay. But it has that instruction in there. Now it's fixing to go to the GUI. Okay, now let's log in. And so actually, I guess that's not exactly an error. It's just some helpful information there at that third one. It all goes by so fast, my brain gets frazzled, and I can't. I'm trying to hurry up and write it down or something, you know, and I don't get an overall view of what's going on. Maybe this will help. And so once we boot up, it's been just running just fine until suddenly, without warning, it locks up. So okay, oops, we're sorted. It looks like boot image, MUZ crashed. Okay, there we go. That's something. Oh, it didn't. I should have clicked on it. See, I was trying to read it. You don't like things staying up and bugging you too long, but when it doesn't stay up long enough for you to read the message and decide what to do, it's pretty crappy. I'm sure you could make that stay up longer somewhere, but where? Yeah, and it didn't leave anything behind for you to go back to it either. So, the boot image crashed. Okay, so, of course, I could probably do this in a desktop video, going and checking log files and all that. I could do that in a desktop video. I was fixing to open up the log file viewer, but it's pretty involved. And with this phone sitting to the right of me, it's right where I need my chair to be. I finally figured out a spot to put it. I couldn't even reach the keyboard or anything, which actually probably wouldn't have mattered that much. I didn't actually use, the only thing I used it for was logging in. But yeah, that boot image crashed. I don't know, it sounds, I don't know what in the world would cause that, except for maybe some apps I installed that maybe have some bugs in them or something. And like I said, VirtualBox, I haven't even messed with it. I installed it, but I haven't even messed with it. So for all I know, it could have, should be showing some errors when I open it up. But I guess I'll do that on a desktop video. So I'm going to stop this little screen video and see how it turns out, and then maybe I'll even play it in a desktop video to go over it and to try to fix. I'll use it. My plan was to use it to try to follow the instructions and fix it if I can. All right, so reach around here and stop it, and then I guess it'll ask me if I want to upload to YouTube or whatever. We'll see.